Awesome. All right. So I'll let him introduce himself a little bit more, but up next is CEO and former Green Beret, Jeremy Milner.
Yeah, thanks. So my name is Jeremy Milner. I did spend some time with 5th and 20th Special Forces Group as an 18 Echo. A couple different moments of my life. I don't consider myself the best of the best out there. Matter of fact, I was lucky to be with them. I've been in the IT space for 20 years now. We've been developing IT solutions for different business, different verticals. And I'm married. I've got two kids, some boxers. I'm the current president for AFSEA chapter for Indiana. I'm also the president for the Special Forces Association chapter for Indiana chapter 500. So I'm very active in nonprofits and just trying to do my part to give back. But today, if you can't hear this, we couldn't get the sound to come through. I'm a very visual and audio guy, so I've got some things I want to play for you for the talk. My talk's more of a pep talk than it is informational like you just got. I mean, he went in some great detail. But I'm not an engineer. I'm a business guy, an entrepreneur, and I see problems like some of us, right? We want to solve problems and take care of things. So I am honored to be here speaking at the InfraGard event today. So ladies and gentlemen, make no doubt about it, we are at war. It's an unconventional war, a silent war in the fifth domain, cyberspace, psyops, and other fashions of non-conventional warfare. I want to open with this video. It's become one of my favorite videos, to be honest with you. Just kind of illustrates what's being done, not only from our side, but everywhere across the world. So without further ado.
Watches and listens in horror, the peaceful pro-democracy demonstration in China comes to a violent and bloody end.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
Wolves hiding nearby, whispering, do or die. Around me, you say your last good night while
is another very important phase of warfare. It has as its target not the body, but the mind of the enemy.
The target of psychological warfare is against the enemy's mind.
It is words and ideas.
Ammunition used by cyber.
Its mission is to influence the thoughts of the enemy soldiers. And at the same time,
is expected and encouraged to study foreign languages and the social sciences such as history, economics, and sociology. He must have a broad and sympathetic understanding of all phases of human experience.
Gripping at my skin, the walls of night closing.
But the use of this force as an integral part of combat has now taken on new form.
My last goodbye.
These are the Psy War soldiers.
So, our lives will never be the same with the amount of information, disinformation, misinformation, false information. And the censorship of information on a scale and pattern is never before seen in history. We have a nation states with the full force of their might all around the world with their tentacles in every facet of our lives, creating narratives, the rabbit holes, and even people with deep research will never know the difference until it's too late. The information is so evasive, so well planned on many fronts to cover their tracks. It's kind of like the Kansas City Shuffle. You know, have you ever seen that movie, Lucky Number 11?
Fuck. Shit. Jesus.
Fuck shit, Jesus is right. I don't understand. Why did they kill Max's family?
New outfit in town. They didn't want somebody else betting on a fixed horse race with him. Trying to make an impression.
That's a fucking story, man.
Charlie Chaplin entered a Charlie Chaplin lookalike contest in Monte Carlo and came in third. Now that's a story. This is something else.
So that's a Kansas City Shuffle?
No. It's just the inciting incident. The catalyst. This is a Kansas City Shuffle.
They look right.
And you go left. Sorry about that, son. Sometimes there's more to life than just living. Besides, you can't have a Kansas City Shuffle without a body.
So, while we're distracted, we are being attacked, infiltrated, shut down, stolen from, degraded to a level we may never fully understand. Our country is being destroyed from inside the wire, some type attacking us now, or waiting on zero-day strikes to attack later. And we are struggling with enough people and resources to guard against it. I came here to thank and honor many of you in the room, the dedicated men working in and around the fifth domain, the cyberspace. You are the unsung heroes protecting our country. You know, it's not always been easy, and this field, as a matter of fact, has been outright hard. The IT and information security industry seems daunting with so much to do and very few peers to help. Because of this, many of you are overworked, overwhelmed, and burnt out. It used to be that attacks were virtual, you know, non-kinetic or not physical. But today, our physical world is tied lock and step with this virtual cyber world. Our world now lives and breathes, dies online and virtuals of zeros and ones. Now that virtual world is attacked, our physical world, way of life and survival is under attack. The federal, state, and local governments, all the businesses would fail to defend themselves without you. And by extension, our way of life and our country, our governments, our economy and military would not survive without you. As a matter of fact, there are roughly 32 million businesses in the United States, not counting state, local, critical infrastructure, schools, and the list goes on. The stats show at least 85% plus are not even cyber resilient. That's over 27 million businesses. And the marketplace is confusing as hell and noisy. Between May of 2020 and 2021, the FBI collected data from 790,000 suspected internet crimes, an increase of more than 300,000 compared to 2019, according to the report. The FBI says losses related to those crimes totaled more than $4.2 billion. It says it received over 28,000 complaints related to COVID and the fraudsters targeting both business and individuals. By 2025, the world is looking at about $10.5 trillion in cyber crimes. Industry is going to spend over $450 billion. Companies are getting attacked every day. Cost of breaches are crushing for small businesses. DoD and other larger companies and primes are starting to make their subs become cyber resilient or at least have a cyber type compliance. Cyber insurance requires companies to do cyber hygiene, or they won't take them, or worse, they'll take them and not pay out when they get breached and find out they didn't do what they said. There are not enough people to handle this. The gaps are huge. 760,000, according to cyberseek.org, are jobs open right now in the cybersecurity space. Globally, it's 3.5 million. That is enough to fill 50 NFL stadiums. That's insane. I would say you are pretty special. I'm going to share with you a thought on a way forward. So just after 9/11, some of you may not know this, but six Special Forces teams, Green Berets, went into Afghanistan as the first American soldiers on the ground. They went in to do what seemed impossible. They took a handful of Afghan warlords that really didn't like each other, but they got them to focus on a common enemy, the Taliban. And they got the Taliban to surrender in 2.5 months. How many in here knew that? Yeah, only a handful of you. They surrendered. Now, of course, we all know that the government wanted to do some nation building and some other things happened, but the Taliban had surrendered. It was amazing. The mission of these types of missions that the special forces and special operators do give us hope and a way forward in an unconventional cyber war, a methodology to work from, how to successfully fight an unconventional warfare, working by, with, and through your local partner force, alongside the people fighting a common enemy. The horse soldiers, which is what's depicted in here, their story reminds us what can be accomplished using this methodology of the Green Berets, this process of by, with, and through. To defeat that common enemy, alongside them providing training, support, equipment, and all types of help. You know, there's one soft troop that's special operation forces, and that's humans are more important than hardware. People are not equipment. People, not equipment, make the critical difference. The right people, highly trained, working as a team, will accomplish the mission with the equipment available. This is our approach at Lionfish and our Cyber Tackle Box. It represents an unconventional approach to try to simplify chaos and a complex issues brought together that brings together expertise, tools, training, support, and equipment in an unconventional way. Our enemies are growing in numbers and attacking at alarming rates. We cannot defend or beat these enemies the way we're going about it today. We need a new approach. We need more help. You are spread thin, fragmented, separated by personal, company, and political interest. We are distracted as a country. We must unite and work as if the whole struggle is depending on you, because it is. Cyber warfare has been emerging a while, and again, we've been distracted as a nation. Many of you have been watching and sounding the alarms, but the enemies of America have grown stronger, bolder, bigger, and better. The Chinese are playing the long game, the 100-year marathon, and we're playing right into their hands, and it's coming to a head by the year 2049 in only a few short years if we don't do something about it. Foreign Policy magazine estimates the Chinese PLA unit 61398, the hacker army, personnel could be close to 100,000. To put this in perspective, our combined services is just over 33,000. 33% of just China alone. Can count Russia, Iran, North Korea, any of those people. You are the equivalent of the Special Operations Force in the Fifth Domain to help protect our country by protecting all of our businesses. If our middle market goes down, our country goes down. But we must unite in this cause or keep going the way we are, and we will fail. Our team at Lionfish is not standing idly by. We continue to watch our country get picked apart by these individual and nation-state controlled hackers. The time for talk is over. We must act, as the Cyberspace Solarium Commission report says, with speed and agility. This is unconventional warfare. It calls for every bit of ingenuity and resources we have available. We are forging a way out of no way. A great solution, again, is using the methodologies of the Green Beret and the by, with, and through our partner forces for a common goal. We have a pathway to success, a strategic plan, and built a platform to help bring everyone together to accomplish this goal. With your help, We'll work to perfect this strategic plan and offer it across Indiana and America. A scalable, economical way to help companies implement good cyber hygiene so they become more cyber resilient, and at the same time bring on tens of thousands of new cybersecurity professionals into the fight. Again, cyber warfare is guerrilla warfare at its core. With that comes a constant changing threatscape that is leaving us short-handed with men and women to defend and protect us. The approach to be a force multiplier when it comes to protection, education, readiness, rebuke to the fight, an effective, efficient way to utilize every resource available to face this enemy. By, with, and through our partner forces, with that level of self-aid, companies can play a good part in their own self-aid and truly become cyber resilient. This isn't a new concept, but it is new in the cyber war. We must put aside our differences. Now is the time to come together on a strategic and unified path. Without it, we are no match for the concerted efforts our enemies are bringing. Thank you for allowing me to share and continue to do what you do. And I will leave you with one final video, because you truly are the heroes of cybersecurity. But we need to come together.
Where have all the good men gone, and where are all the gods? Where's the streetwise Hercules to fight the rising odds? Isn't there a white knight upon a fiery steed? Late at night, I toss and I turn and I dream of what I need.
Is that everyone?
What, you wanted more?
Somewhere after midnight, in my wildest fantasy, somewhere just beyond my reach, somewhere reaching back for me, racing on the thunder and rising with the heat.
Avengers!
You said 1 out of 14 million, we win, yeah? Tell me this is it.
If I tell you what happens, it won't happen.
Oh,
Thank you very much.